In the next videos, we will discuss solar cell technologies based on chalcogenide materials. Chalcogenide is a chemical term that refers to all the compounds that contain chalcogen anions from group 6 in the periodic table, indicated with the Roman number 6. In a later video, we will discuss the cadmium telluride technology, which is based on the tellurium anion from group 6. In this video, we'll introduce the group of chalcopyrite solar cells, primarily known from the copper indium gallium diselenide or CIGS solar cells. Both cadmium telluride and CIGS are thin film solar cell technologies. This graph, published in 2016, shows the market share of these two technologies, as well as thin film amorphous silicon as a percentage of the global PV production per year. One can see that the market in the last couple of years, the share of thin film technologies has dropped, which is primarily caused by a vast increase in production capacity of the crystalline silicon technology. Nevertheless, there is still some potential for CIGS and cadmium telluride that takes advantage of the thin film technology as a benefit such as a versatile product integration and lightweight applications. The graph in this slide shows the annual global PV module production of the three most important thin film technologies, and we can see that the capacity for CIGS has not been growing strongly over the last number of years. In this video, we will show the progression and conversion efficiency of CIGS. You will learn about the most relevant properties of the complex material that CIGS is, and we will discuss the conductivity type, which can be controlled directly by the material composition. First, we will look at the overview of the achieved conversion efficiencies for solar cells over the years for the CIGS solar cell technology. The National Renewable Energy Laboratory, abbreviated to NREL, in the United States keeps track of the record conversion efficiencies for all solar cell technologies. In this graph from early 2017, we see that the record efficiency for a CIGS cell under one sun illumination is 22.6%, implying a high potential for this technology. This efficiency was achieved by the German research institute Zentrum für Sonnenenergie und Wasserstoff, often abbreviated to ZSW, or when pronounced in German, ZSW. Now we know the potential of CIGS-based solar cell, let's start with the chemical composition and structure of this material. Chalcopyrite materials consist of elements in group 1, 3 and 6. Many combinations of the elements shown here are potential solar cell materials. However, the electronic band gap of most materials is too wide. The most common combination is a mixture of copper, indium diselenide or CIS and copper gallium diselenide or CGS. Also, sulfur can be included in the structure, partially replacing the selenide fraction in the material. We then arrive at the following chemical expression with X and Y ranging between 0 and 1. The chalcopyrite structure shown here on the right receives its name from the tetrahedral bonded copper iron disulfide structure. In this case, however, the iron atoms are replaced by gallium and indium atoms, while the sulfur is partially or completely replaced by selenium. The structure is rather complex, but you can clearly see the tetrahedral structure in which every atom is bonded to four neighbors. By changing the ratio between indium and gallium, X, and the ratio between sulfur and selenide, Y, the electronic band gap of the material can be varied significantly between 1 and 1.7 electron volts, as can be seen in this table. Adding gallium to the structure, for instance, increases the band gap of the material. This material has a very high absorption coefficient, which makes it a suitable material for the thin film technology. And on top of this, the diffusion length of electrons can be up to a few micrometers. In the previous lecture series, we discussed that a P or N-type material can be obtained by adding impurity atoms to the structure. However, the type of conductivity in CIGS is determined by the intrinsic chemical composition of the material. P or n-type conductivity can be obtained by changing the composition of the material in two different ways. The so-called molecularity of the copper indium diselenide, delta M, is given by this expression. This ratio tells if the composition is copper-rich or indium-rich. On the other hand, the non-stoichiometry, delta S, tells if the material is selenium-rich or poor. This diagram shows the type of conductivity for a large number of compositions. When the material is indium-rich and selenium-poor, leading to a negative delta M and a negative delta S, the material will show n-type conductivity related to excess indium and selenium deficiency. We can see that by making the composition copper-rich and selenium-rich, leading to a positive delta M and delta S, the material will show p-type conductivity. This is related to the participation of metal vacancies and excess selenium. In the standard CIGS technology, p-type material is used as absorber layer. To summarize this video, so far we have discussed the very promising CIGS research cell efficiency of up to 22.6%. We've shown that the most commonly used child copperite structure for solar cell applications, which is copper indium gallium diselenide disulfide with X and Y between 0 and 1. And finally, we've discussed how the conductivity type of CIGS is determined, namely by the composition of the material rather than by extrinsic doping of impurity atoms.